it is with you, inshallah. So what is the meaning of Nasrun?
Help.
Alhamdulillah, to help. Then Fathun. Ja'alun. Rizqun. Alhamdulillah. Then Falkun. Okay, Dukhul, Masud Jannah. To enter. Alhamdulillah. Oh, I translated. Alhamdulillah. Then Zikrun. Kufrun. Disbelief. Yeah, to deny Allah's mercy, all this, okay? So, Ibadatun. To worship, okay? Alhamdulillah. So, if we calculate from new verbs, we learn Fathun, we learn Ja'alun, to. Okay, Fi'alun also. Although already we know Huat, okay? So, Fi'alun, then Fathun, then Ja'alun, Tiga, then Nasrun, Ampat, Khalqun, Lima, Rizqun, Enam, then Zikrun, Tuju, then Ibadatun, Lapan, then Dukhulun, Simbilan, then Zikrun, Sepulu, Tilka Asharatun Kamila, Tilka Asharatun Kamila, that is completed, mashallah. So we go to further study, inshallah, we start new one. So still, I think it's empty. We do some practices, then let them come, okay? Zakara. Zakara. Make loud sound, so they will think, oh, class has started, okay? Zakara. Zakaru. Zakarta. Zakartu. Zakartu. Zakarna. Zakara. Don't go to Jakarta now, because you say, Jakarta, Ustad, I go to Jakarta. No, later on, okay, because you still, Ustad did not go, so you follow me. Wait for me. Okay, again, Zakara, Zakaru, Zakarta, Zakartu, Zakartu, Zakarna, Zakarat. Mudare? Yes, Kuru. Yazkurun, tazkuru, azkuru, nazkuru, tazkuru, uzkur, uzkuru, la tazkuru, zakir, mazkur, zikrun. Inshallah, alhamdulillah. Now we go to another one. Can we start the chapter? I think we start, Bismillah. They will come, inshallah. So, to start this chapter, I need to talk a little. Because there is a difference. Dr. Abdul Aziz, he is from India. And you know, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, usually we follow Mazhab of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Like Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei. This region is mostly dominated by Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah. So, as the author, he is the follower of, whether he is following perfectly or not, but as he is from India, and book also published from India, he followed the style of Imam Shafi'i, Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. But it's okay because I am already here for 6 years, so I know what you do in your salah, how you start all this. So what is going to happen when these chapters, when anything comes to us, we will follow Imam Shafi rahimahullah's practice. Because maximum of you from Shafi background, okay? So it's better. That's why from this phase onwards, some of the topic I have to explain from your perspective. Otherwise, because you don't practice this one, so it will be, you will not get it, okay? So that's why, please be with me, listen to me, and then inshallah it will be clear. Help me, for example, in the book we started with Subhanaka Allahumma, but no, I will take your help, and then you have to tell me how you start Salah. Okay? Yes, Ustaz, can you help me? I need your help. Come. So now, Ustaz will help me. Your Ustaz will help me For example, how you start Salah? Let's say, if you are here from this, any, it's okay. Okay, it's standard. Okay, look. So, Ustaz came to play. How, what does he do? Just coming to place of Salat. What does he do? Tell me everybody. Yes? Straight, okay. Okay, he already stood straight, no problem. Then? Yes? Niya. Okay, that will be later. Niya, right? Niya, actually, ulama has different opinions. Some ulama says you already came, so it's okay. Some ulama said no, you make niya. So we follow, that one is perfect, no contradiction, we make niya, okay? Okay? What do you make niya? Now I do the anusalliya for the zuhri, al baraka, like that, okay? And I hope all of you know, you understand already, right? Meaning that. That means it's still not clear. Okay, sir. Help me, on by on.
How do you say like that? It's interview. Okay, now I get
it. Yeah, niya has to come together this while we are talking about
it. Oh, okay. Okay. So what is the niya?
Allah. Okay, can you... I... Sajid, I wish my young.
Okay, okay, Bahasa Malayo. Oh, okay, you also, everybody make Bahasa Malayo?
Yes.
Okay, then, okay. Then I just...
reading. Sajaku, Solah, Duhur. So three elements must be there.
Oh, okay. This is must. Okay. So, like you, okay, then Salat Zuhur, and?
I'm Sajaku.
Okay, relax. Oh, Zuhur, yes. For Zuhur, and also, yes. So, this is the mandatory. This is the mandatory one, but for example, you can make your that, okay, or for example, as we make, now I do an usalliya, salat al-zuhri, arba'a raka'atin, mutawazzihan, ila jihad al-ka'wat al-sharifat, Allah akbar, like that, okay? Yeah, like.
I'm praying, fardu, zuhur, three.
Okay, three main, okay?
I'm praying, fardu, zuhur.
Okay. So this is the low, I mean minimum, okay? So, okay, I think it's okay. I'll not take long time about it, okay? Then you make takbir. Okay, say that. Okay, that means niya baikal.
Yes.
Niya baikal. Okay, alhamdulillah, done. So you make takbir. Then after takbir, what do you do? Dua iftitah. What is dua iftitah? Allahumma Allahu Akbar kabira alhamdulillah kaseera subhanallahi bukratan wasira. So what is the meaning? Alhamdulillah, all the praises due to Allah. Alhamdulillah, clear, right? Yesterday also I explained, so no need more time. Alhamdulillah, no, Allahu Akbar kabira. So you see, there is another word, kabira. What is the meaning of kabira?
Great.
That means Allah is the greatest. It's not just you are telling normally. No, with determination. Greatly. Meaning that kabira means, if you translate word by word, that means greatly. He is the greatest, greatly greatest. What does it mean? Meaning that you are declaring this with your firm determination. There is no confusion. Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar, Kabira. It's emphasizing. Allahu Akbar is enough already. But using again the word Kabira is emphasizing. Indeed, greatly, confirm, without any doubt, with determination, Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar, Kabira. Walhamdulillahi Kathira. Alhamdu, and Alhamdu, you help me quick because I already taught you, right? All the praises are for Allah. Lillahi, alhamdulillahi, kathira. I already told you, right? And a lot, banya, right? A lot, okay? Alhamdulillahi, kathira. Wa subhanallahi, bukrata wa asila. And glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or I glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when? In the morning also in the evening. What does it mean? You are praying Zuhur, but you are saying Bukrata wa Asila. Bukra Asila, the significance of using the word Bukrata wa Asila is meaning, the means meaning is like that. Start, you are starting your day with remembering Allah, with Allah's praises, your day will become complete, full of barakah by Allah's mercy. So, also, when you say in the beginning, you say bukra, it represents the whole day. When you say bukrata wa asila, evening, also evening, as it is the starting of night, it also represents whole night. So to never be upset, oh, I have prayed Fajr, that's all, no need to do it. No, cannot do like that, okay? Also, I prayed, that's all, no need more. No. Actually, the significance of using Bukra wa Asila is that this is the beginning of the day, also beginning of the night. It covers everything. It covers everything, okay? So we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and also in the evening. Then? Asila, then? Wajjahtu. Tell me, can anybody guess what kind of verb is it? Is it past or present? Past. Is it singular or plural?
Singular.
Still you are on track. Is it third person or second person? First person. Wajjahtu. You remember? Wajjaha, wajjahu. Wajjahta, wajjahtu. Wajjahtu. I face. Verb, right? Then wajhi. Can anybody help me? Did I teach you wajhi? Wajhul is face. Then wajhi. Did I teach you? Rabbi, kitabi, nabiyi. So wajhul face. Wajhi, my face. Wajhi, my face. Okay? From today on, any Arabic you have to check whether you learned or not. Then inshallah it will be helpful. Okay? So wajhtu. Was here? Lillazi. Li. Did I teach you Li?
Yes.
Untuk, right? Li. Allazi, did I teach you?
Yes.
I mean, somehow it was discussed. Okay. Allazi, the one who. Allazi means the one who. Lillazi, fatara. Fatara also similar to khalaqa. It's synonym. It's like almost same. Not exactly the same. They have other significance. But the main meaning is also khalaqa. Like that, okay? Created. Alladhi fatara, who created. As-samawat, already you understand. Al-art, also you understand. In English also art, okay? Art, okay? Yeah, a lot of Arabic words in English, you know? Because, it is different linguistics, I don't talk now. Okay, anyway, fatara as-samawati wal-arda, hanifa. What is the meaning of hanifa? Yes? Honestly, sincerely, not straight, okay? Some of you say straight, no. It's like, for example, it's talking about you. You faced your face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with highest level of sincerity. Hanif, Hanif is the pure, pure, very pure. I mean, no dust, no, I mean, anything, okay? I mean, any negative things. You are just surrendering completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your utmost purity. Okay? Hanifa, Hanifa. So check whether you are Hanif or not, or just by time only. Hanif, Hanif. Cannot. Allah check. Allah has all the machines. Okay? To check whether you are Hanif or not. Okay? Inshallah, we should not leave to say Hanifa. We try to maintain our heart to make it Hanif, inshallah, okay? وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا. Then, وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. What does it mean? And, ma, this ma negative. Okay, sorry, I forgot to teach you one thing. I just help you. Oma, no, it's okay, but ma. Okay, did you take my number?
Yes.
Okay. And also, when I give you break, send me the WhatsApp, so that in future, any program, anything, I also will be connected. Okay, especially when the program will be organized by yourself or so patronage, then you will get the announcement. But for example, I have some other programs, Allah make me like Zakir Noel. Okay, then I invite you, my students will be in the first row, okay? So don't forget it. Also, give me your number, just say Salam or AS anything. Maybe when I will open internet, I will get your number, okay? I'll save it. Okay, so now, also I will take maybe on list from Ustaz, so that it will be easy. But, I mean, to say it will take time. Better you send me Salam or something like that, okay? Look, ma, not ibu, okay, this is another ma, okay? So ma can be used before mudar. So I erase this, my number, okay? Look, just remember, three minimum, or just for you three. They have some more explanation, but just three you remember. Ma, before Mahdi, when it is used before Mahdi, you remember Mahdi? Past. Okay? Nasara, for example, Nasara, right? Nasara. If you add Mahdi, sorry, if you add ma before this nasara, then it's negative past. Ma nasara means he didn't help. Nasara, he helped. Ma nasara, he didn't help. Khalaqa, he created. Khalaqa, ma khalaqa, he didn't create, right? Now you ask me, oh, so it's before you taught us, min sharri ma khalaq, ma has another meaning. That's why I have to write. I cannot just speak, then you will forget. Just write down the examples, you will remember. Just remember, ma is used to give negative meaning for maadi, not mudari, maadi. Just remember. Okay, before maadi, if you put ma, it gives you negative meaning for past tense. Ma khalaqa, he didn't create. He didn't create. Ma nasara, he didn't help. Ma zahaba, he didn't go. Clear? Okay, number one. Number two, min sharri ma khalaq, for example, min sharri ma khalaq. This ma, again, it can come before verb, before noun also, but usually when it comes before verb, okay, it gives you the meaning of what, min shari ma khalaq, from what Allah created, okay, the negative impact of what Allah created. So ma can give you a meaning of what, okay? Yeah, what, okay? So, but this meaning of what can be used in two different ways. One is here, like description, okay, like description. Another one is in the beginning of the sentence. What is the beginning of the sentence? How? Ma di nuka. Yeah, ma di nuka. So, ma di nuka, okay? Ma di nuka, okay? So, what is your religion? Ma kitabuka. Ma biladuka, biladun, state, okay, country. Ma biladuka. It's asking somebody, asking any question, okay? So, ma ismuka, ma biladuka, ma dinuka. You understand? So, to make it easy, you can just say that one for negative, another for description, another for asking any question, okay? So just remember it. Clear? These three. Another one, we have modare. Modare is present and future together, right? So modare, we have la. To make modare negative, we just put la. I already told you when I was discussing Surah Al-Kafirun. La a'budu, la a'kulu, la azhabu, La aqra'u, I don't read. Again, this is a little bit tough, but in the beginning of our class, it's okay. I hope you understand, right? If it is in the middle, maybe tough. But now I think all are okay. We pray, we do glance, okay? La, be careful. Every single haraka, you understand haraka? Yeah, haraka is very important in Arabic. La, two types of la we have. Okay? One is negative order, another one is just normal negative. You understand? How? I tell you. A'budu, I worship. When you add la, and there is no change in haraka of mudare, you understand? Then it will give you negative meaning for present tense. A'budu means I worship. La a'budu means I don't worship. Clear? No change in the basic form of mudare. Clear? Just remember, please. But if you change, if you see some changes, look, I show you. La taj'al. La taj'al. Okay, give me the answer. Yaj'alu. Yaj'aluna. Taj'alu. Taj'aluna. So second person, what was the form for singular? Taj'alu. Right or wrong? Okay, right. Taj'alu. If we want to make normal negative sentence, what to do? La taj'alu. Means you don't make. This is all meaning. But if I order, la taj'al. La taj'al. Order, then that it will be sukun. No more dhamma. If dhamma, normal. If sukun, order. You understand? La taj'alu means you don't make, usually you don't do that, okay? But when I say la taj'al, then negative order. Also, taj'alu, then plural? Taj'aluna. But what is the plural for negative order? La taj'alu. We no more say la taj'aluna. Because if we say la taj'aluna, then it will be negative mudare. Negative mudare, not negative order. You got it? Yes. Just remember these 5 points I told you. 3 points I told you about ma. 2 points I told you about la. Please remember. Ma for question. Ma for description. Ma for negative. La for negative. Two types of negative. Negative order. Normal negative, okay? That's negative statement. Okay, negative statement. So, negative statement, then we don't change anything from the basic form of mudare. But when we give it negative order, then first sentence we put sukun, other we remove noon. La taj'al, singular, it is sukun at the last letter. Then plural, la taj'alu. We no more say la taj'aluna. We say la taj'alu. Clear? Alhamdulillah. Everybody say Alhamdulillah. So now we go to another one. Okay. Why did I talk a lot about it? What was the issue? Oma ana minal mushriki. Oma ana minal mushriki. So now you understand? Oma ana minal mushriki. Ma for what? Is it description or negative? Negative. Negative sentence can come also before now. Like now. Oma ana minal mushriki. Like this, okay? Noun or preposition. It can come. Not only for madi, okay? So this is for negative. Oma ana minal mushriki. May Allah help us. We talked a lot about ma. But it is very important. It's very important, okay? I hope you will remember it. Inshallah?
Sure.
Okay then, Omana min al-Mushrikin. Then.
Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen.
Don't make it otherwise. I already told you yesterday that we just say by our sound. Nice, no, inna salati. But touch your heart. Ask yourself, are you really doing everything for Allah or for your society? If you don't go to Juma, other people will say, oh, this is not good man, like this. So you just go. But are you really going to satisfy Allah or not? Correct yourself. If you are not going for Allah, try to change your attitude. Try to develop your ikhlas. Allah will help you, okay? Inna salati, indeed my salat, wa nusuki, and my sacrifice, wa mahyaya, and my life. This is the word it knocks here, okay? Allahu Akbar. You are saying that my life is for Allah. It's not fun. It's not fun, brothers and sisters. You are telling my life is for Allah, but you check, you don't have the time to recite the Quran. You have time to read all the messages from your friends, WhatsApp, Facebook, WeChat, all these 3 hours, 4 hours, but you don't have the time. But you just say, in mahyaya mamati, it's not real one, it's not real, it's not practical. Change your life. Change your this kind of practice. Make your life for Allah. Allah will help you to be in Jannah, inshallah. Okay? So, please, when you say any single word in your salah, correct your intention. Correct. Mahyaya, you have to mean it. If you don't mean, then you are doing like hypocrisy, okay? It's not good. You say mahyaya, be ready. Are you really ready that you sacrifice your life for Allah? Not, then you develop your heart by zikr, by tilawah, more and more. Inshallah, Allah will help you. Amamati? Also for Allah. We cannot commit suicide. We cannot do anything against ourselves because I am not the owner of this body. I am not the controller of these functions. Allah gave this health, this body, shape, everything by Allah. You don't have any right to disturb yourself. That's why Islam is a balanced life, balanced code of life. Why? Even Prophet ﷺ mentioned that for you have rights. You cannot love Allah and then wake up whole night. No, cannot. You have to make the balance, you have to sleep. You have to sleep because Prophet ﷺ said, وَلِنَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقْ. For yourself you have right. وَلِزَوْجَتِكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقْ. For your husband, for your wife you have rights. For walidain you have rights. For the Prophet ﷺ you have rights. For Allah you have rights. So Islam is a complete code of life, meaning that it gives all the rights to everyone. This is Allah's right. Salah fi waqtiha. One time you pray. Okay, for your wife, for your husband, you give them time. Also the other support. For your children, you do your job with them. For your parents, you do your job. You cannot just pray in the masjid all the time and then think you are a perfect pious Muslim. No. Okay? Please. Correct it, okay? Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. So, mahyaya, my hayat, my complete life is for Allah. It doesn't mean that complete life you just pray. No. Complete life you surrender to Allah's rule, Allah's guideline, as Allah guided, as Prophet ﷺ guided. Prophet guided like this, you make balance. This will be also for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Even sometimes maybe I told you that, okay, Saturini, I was laughing. No, it's not the issue. To protect yourself, you take something for you. Protect, help your parents, you give to them something. To put your children, you donate. It will be also sadaqah. Best sadaqah what you give for your family. Okay? So don't be confused by my lecture. My focus is whatever you do for Allah. Even for your husband, wife, parents, children, make the niyyah of Allah. You told us, your prophet guided us, taught us like this. So everything actually for you. Even I give money for my parents, is also for you. Okay? May change the niyyah. Allah will give barakah. Say Ameen.
Amin.
Inna salati wa nusuki ya mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin.
Again, tell me.
Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin.
Again.
Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin.
And try to tell Allah by your heart, not by the mouth. Because the word of mouth, it will also reach, but it will be slow. Communication by heart is so stronger. It will reach Allah very quickly. Even by mouth, it will, reach, because Allah has the capacity to listen everything, okay? That's why. But it will not be able to motivate Allah, to attract Allah's attention. If you want to attract Allah's attention, you have to talk by your heart.
Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen.
And yesterday we talked about Ikhlas, even Surah Ikhlas, did we discuss? Yesterday we talked about Inna wal a'malu bin niyyat, you remember? All are related. And about Ikhlas, this is the best, best means like, most important verse about Ikhlas is this one. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati, from the Quran. From Hadith, innama al-amalu bin niyyah, that's okay. But from the Quran, this is the foundation of Ikhlas. This verse, inna salati wa nusuki, is also from Quran. This is the foundation of Ikhlas. If you are weak in Ikhlas, recite this one, study the tafsir of this verse, inshallah, Allah will help you to have Ikhlas more and more, inshallah, okay? Okay, after that, what do you do? Inna salati, then after? La sharika la. Already I explained. No need to talk about it. There is no partner. Then? Obizalika. Obizalika. Umirtu. Can anybody guess? Umirtu is singular or plural?
Singular.
Madi or madare? Madi. Very good students, alhamdulillah. Brilliant staff of Petronas. Welcome, alhamdulillah. MashaAllah. Okay. Madi. Singular. Third person or first person?
Yes.
Astaghfirullah. You thought that Ustaz gave the wrong answer. No. First person. Umirtu. Ba'altu. Nasartu. Umirtu. Yeah, first person. Okay. Yeah, okay. So, first person, singular number. Okay. Umirtu. I was ordered. Or I am ordered. For what? Bizalika. Means what you say like that. About all this Ikhlas, you are not committing the shirk like this, you are ordered to follow this style, okay? Abidhanika umirtu wa ana minal muslimin. You are saying that, yes, yes, I am among Muslims. Confirm?
Yes.
No. By sound only, no. By heart bullet, but by sound, no. Because Muslim is not just the name of a Muslim, okay? I am Muslim. No. The description of Muslim is different. Muslim, Arabic word, Islam means the one, to surrender. Islam means to surrender. Muslim means the one who surrenders. Do you surrender to Allah? If no, then problem. You surrender only, just say Allahu Akbar. At that time, oh, all as usual, like kafir, like other people. Then what is the, how you claim that you are a Muslim? Maybe your name in the government is in your registry as a Muslim, okay? But in the registry of Allah, to be Muslim, you have really, really to be, you have to be a Muslim perfectly. Udkhulu fi silmi kafa. This is not my word. Allah said, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. Udkhulu. What is the meaning of udkhulu?
Enter.
Udkhulu fi silmi. Silmun means Islam. Fil Islami, for example, kafatan. So, enter the deen, yeah, the religion of Islam, completely. Kafatan. Completely. Perfectly. Okay? So it's not my word. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. So then you can claim you are a Muslim. Look, if, let's say, if any sweeper go to Prime Minister's office and try to sit on his chair, what will happen? All the secretary will pick him mad, crazy like that, okay? Gila, okay? Gila Besar, very bad, bad type of gila that you came to Prime Minister's office and tried to. It will happen or not? So, do you understand what I mean? Meaning that Allah gave us this name that, okay, wa ana min al muslimin, for example, this is also from Quranic verse. You are the one who will surrender. But you are arrogant, you feel proud, you don't surrender to Allah. How come you claim you are a Muslim? Please check. Check again. Before you meet Allah, check. So that you will not face any danger or any problem. Check now, okay? Am I really a Muslim or not? If not, correct yourself. Develop. Slowly you develop your characteristics and become perfect Muslim. Because Allah also says in another verse, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Never die. لَا تَمُوتُنَّ. Never you die until you become a Muslim. وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. What does it mean? Because if you are not a perfect Muslim, you will face problem in Qabr. You will face problem in Sirat. You will face problem in other stages. Allahu Akbar. It's a problem. So Allah taught us, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Never die until you become a perfect Muslim. So from today, try your best to be a perfect Muslim so that you will not face the difficulty, or any punishment in Qabr or any other places. You know about Qabr? Ya Allah, it will take long time, but alami barza, we don't have the idea. Please study about it. Then you will have the idea. I tell you just within 1 minute, 2 minutes. The people who are good, righteous people, like complete Muslim or Solah, for example, Allah will give you the chance, is like the first day of your marriage. You know, like a special bed, a smell, flowers, everything. Okay? It's like that. It's hadith. Prophet ﷺ mentioned that any person, Solah, dies and you put the cover, you lift, then angels will put the mattress or like this, the bed, prepare the bed as a bed of your first day of your marriage, that two persons are meeting and it's nice, they smell, everything is so nice. This will be like that, and you will pass the time until the Jannah, until you could meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment very happily, nicely. But the people who are not good, who are not performing the deen perfectly, who are not following Allah's order, what will happen? Every single step they will suffer. You know, they will suffer. Lot of discussion, I don't have the time, Ya Allah. Even the angels will come in a mood. First time you will be so afraid. Who is this? Who is this? Why is like that? How is his behavior? Why is he approaching me like so angrily, so aggressively, so arrogantly like that? He will be so afraid after he saw the angel of punishment. Because he did not perform the good deeds. Okay? So very simple thing is that we have to surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before we die. Okay? May Allah give us tawfiq. But as we don't know our destination, you don't know that whether you will die tomorrow or today or after 1 month, 2 months. We don't know. And recently it happened to my country. Believe me, it can happen anywhere. On district commissioner of Bangladesh, we have district. Like you have a state, we have division. We call it division. Okay, part of the country. Under the division, we have 6 or 7 districts. Okay? So, on of the district commissioner, the highest position of the district commissioner, they have the divisional commissioners meeting. On of the district commissioner, that's everybody, like 10:30 is the meeting. You can check online also, okay? Like the death of the district commissioner in Bangladesh. Maybe, YouTube also I saw. Meeting is going to start soon, very soon. Then what happened? Like sitting here, this is the door. Even the security said salam to him. He said he put the file and then phenomenon like this. He came here, even I saw the video, security says Salah. He talked little and even talking.
Look, his seat is like that. He just still the phone for love, finish. Just recently.
And last night, I read another story. Whole group of a district was going to river cruise. You understand, river cruise? Okay? They had big ship all together, family. Even in the middle to take glances, somebody fall down and then finish. One of the member of the position, I forgot. This is life. No, you don't know any limit. You don't know any particular time when are you going to die. So better, as Allah said, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Better you prepare now. Now is the time. Have you heard the lecture of Martin Luther King? I have a dream. And many times he said, now is the time. So I don't repeat the words of Martin Luther King, but I just remind you, now is the time. Now is the time to make tawbah. Now is the time to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now is the time to prepare for your hereafter. Now, not later. May Allah give us the tawfiq, this understanding. Amen. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Then, takbir. Oh, takbir already you did earlier, right? Yes, okay. Then, Mr. Fatah, we already discussed. Okay, so Alhamdulillah, clear. So from today, when you recite Inna Salati, remember my points that I told you, okay? Inna Salati wa Nusuki wa Mahyaya wa Mamati Lillahi Rabbil Alameen. Inna Salati wa Nusuki wa Mahyaya wa Mamati لله رب العالمين إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. You drive, you recite, so that you make as your slogan to change your life. إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. So that it will be in your heart. Okay?